program I was in was the International Affairs Fellowship for tenured scholars.
I participated in the International Affairs Fellowship.
So the one I did was in Japan.
IAF in Canada.
The Council on Foreign Relations International Affairs Fellowship is an opportunity for academics to become practitioners and for practitioners to become academics. The virtue of the IAF is that it allows fellows to pick their own adventure.
I really wanted to do an intense and long-term research project. The demands of my daily work didn't allow for me to do that. And so the IAF seemed like a great experience that would give me the time.
I left Vietnam in 1978, and I stayed 11 months in two refugee camps. That experience connects that I want to find ways to give back and help people who are marginalized and disenfranchised. So the intersection between law, policy, and finance allowed me to give me the tools in order to make an impact.
I was placed in the Bureau of Africa Affairs. My job with the Bureau is to work on U.S.-Africa multilateral policy. I was part of the U.S. delegation to the United Nations High Level Week. I played an integral role in setting up the U.S.-Africa Leader Summit.
I'm an Arctic expert, and I really wanted the opportunity to dive deeper and move from the strategy to execution. And so getting a chance to understand how Canada in particular is thinking about their strategic objectives in the Arctic.
CFR and Hitachi, which was the sponsor of the fellowship, made it easy for me to basically move my whole life to Tokyo.
I spent my time specifically working on the Senate Foreign Relations Committee as a legislative fellow. And I certainly came away from that experience with a much greater appreciation for the role that Congress plays in U.S. foreign policy. It's useful for students to have professors and faculty that have some lived experience, so it's not just all concepts and theory.
At the Treasury Department, I served as strategic advisor to the Deputy Assistant Secretary for Asia. I was often asked to accompany some Treasury officials to very sensitive and highly classified NSC meetings, and that was a tremendous learning experience for me to watch the policymaking process in action.
I am researching the history of diversity in the U.S. Foreign Service. I'm hoping to provide new historical perspectives that people can factor into the policymaking process.
My post placement in Canada is Institute for Research and Public Policy. They're like a second family to me.
So I now have a network that spans, you know, Europe, Canada, and the Asia Pacific, and these are all people I met directly through my experience at CFR.
I think the program offers a lot of benefits. First, of course, is making it financially possible for people to take on these particular roles, right? Basically subsidizing your time in government.
Where I think our work has effect on the international relations space is that demonstrates that multilateralism is not dead. In many cases, it's a preferred method to conflict resolution. It's a demand signal from African countries.
What can we do now to really invest in the entrepreneurs? Because it's a long game. Over time, they create jobs, create wealth, create opportunities. You build the community.
CFR IAF Fellowship opened far more doors than I could have ever imagined. And really, it led me in a lot of ways to the current job that I have now as a new Deputy Assistant Secretary of Defense for Arctic and Global Resilience.
Working on economic issues has given me the opportunity to become more of a national security generalist. I understand the military and security side of things, and now I better understand the economic and finance side of things. It propelled me to the next level in my career.
It allowed me to pivot my career quite extensively to be more of an Asia Pacific focus.
I will publish a book made this year.
My ability to have this fellowship has had a bigger impact on people who are historically excluded from academia, from policy world, and seeing that it's possible to do the kind of work that they aspire to. Let them know that this is such a once-in-a-lifetime valuable experience to have, and it will only pay positive dividends.
So what the IAF is doing, and really it's what CFR does every day, is it's identifying and bringing together the best and brightest minds in national security and foreign policy, and elevating the conversation as they elevate their careers and propelling all of us to the next level.
When we look at those alums, we see the folks that really have a huge impact on the conversations that we're having, the questions that we're asking, and the direction that we are headed.
Anyone considering applying, just do it.
For me, I am better human being because of CFR experience.